arrived here at the University of Arizona College of Pharmacy, I met Heidi, and she is certainly a drug delivery type of scientist. And we had been working on this old compound, so over 100 years old, called Suramin at the time. And we were looking at actually for its use in a kidney disease. But at the same time, we did some preliminary studies and showed that it may be effective in wound healing.
Suramin is a polysulfonated naphthalurea drug. It's been around for a number of years. It's approved in Europe for a different disease state. And so we're using it in oral mucositis for wound healing. Specifically, wound healing, oral mucositis is what happens in cancer patients when they have chemotherapy and radiation in head and neck cancers. So that kind of treatment causes mucositis. And mucositis is actually wounds in the oral cavity inside the mouth. So these are open wounds. It's also in the throat. It affects breathing, swallowing, eating, and these wounds are chronic and they can become infected. So it really affects patients' quality of life.
When you're dealing with a drug that's going to be in the oral cavity, right, which is always wet, right? And so the issue is you have to find something, right, that you can embed into a matrix such that it'll stick to the area that is a wound and then release the drug before it's washed away.
The other patient population for wound healing is diabetics who have foot ulcers in particular. So it can help with healing of the wounds on their feet to prevent loss of limb.
At some point, Heidi made a number of particles and we think they need to be tested. Well, neither Heidi nor I actually have expertise in models of oral mucositis. So then how the world is small, I had a friend who actually is a dentist who studies oral mucositis, and I knew him at the Medical University of South Carolina. So then we call Keith Kirkwood up and say, hey, would you want to partner with us because you actually understand the oral cavity and wound healing? And so we brought him into the picture, so we brought in three people then to be able to move this project forward.
One of the innovations that we have put into this is that it's patient-friendly, and the patient can self-administer, not with no injection, so it's non-invasive, what we call non-invasive. It's applied topically, so it's targeted to the wound, directly to the site of action. So systemic exposure is minimized significantly as opposed to intravenous, which is not only invasive, but a physician or a healthcare provider would have to administer it. So there's innovation in how this can be administered. It will help the patient compliance, and ultimately healing. So what's exciting about this is that it's a first in class. So and that's a big thing. So it brings in a whole new way of treatment, not only being targeted, but in terms of the pharmacological mechanism of action. So it's a first in class treatment for two big patient populations where there's a big unmet medical need. In the diabetic population, but also in the cancer population. And these complications are therapeutically limiting. In other words, it affects how those diseases are treated. So what's really exciting is that you can make a big difference